Well, guys, I've spent the last, like, hour and a half on the bike simulating this, and it's finally time as I'm back to my Madden 2009 PSP franchise mode off screen, as I'm into 2013 season, as we're now one-fifth of the way done for this franchise. As you remember, just a week or so ago, we simulated the Super Bowl for 2002, where the Panthers beat the Ravens and actually won back-to-back Super Bowls, first time since the 2003-2004 Patriots. But now it's time for 2015 season, we're down to our Super Bowl. But before we get to that, I wanted to show the stand-ins, since I'm not going to do a timeline video this time. In fact, I'll probably delete the R1 so you can see how the teams went throughout the year. So, of course, we start off in the AFC North. The Ravens managed to get back into the playoffs at 12-4, although they struggled at first. They managed to get back in. Bengals had a really strong start to the year, but they crapped out. The Browns, the reverse, struggled really bad, but had a strong finish. The Steelers are crap. And in the AFC South, the Jaguars got back. They were supposed to be maybe a Super Bowl contender this year, but they kind of struggled near the end of the year, but got in at 12-4. Titans still struggling, being mediocre at 8-8. The Texans fell apart to 6-10. The Colts, their first year out, Peyton struggled at 6-10, although they did make a nice comeback at the end of the year. In the AFC East, the Bills, out of nowhere, after going 13-3 last year, one game short of the Super Bowl, they went 15-1, the best record in this franchise mode, as they clinched home field advantage throughout the playoffs, and they look very scary. And then the Dolphins, 13-3, although they did not play as good as it looked like right there, but they had an easy schedule, so it was easy for them to get to 13-3. And the Patriots, 4-12, the Jets, 3-13. And the AFC West, the Broncos finally came back. First time in this franchise mode, made the playoffs, ended their 8-year drought, and they actually managed to get first round bye too. The Chiefs have really fallen apart this last 2 years after they've been to the Super Bowl, and they are barely hanging on for dear life right now. They're going to have to really get a rebuild next year, or else they might miss the playoffs completely, because there are teams that can maybe challenge them. The Chargers continue to regress, and the Raiders, although they're not a good team, they actually had a solid year, 5-11 finish, not bad at the end of the year. I think they won like 3 in a row. Then we go over to the NFC side, start with the NFC North. The Lions, I thought they were going to struggle this year. They ended up improving and getting 12-4 once again, getting that first round bye. The Packers improved the record-wise, but they still cannot get out of that wild card spot, although statistically they didn't play as good. The Vikings, they had a terrible start to the year, but all of a sudden they came out of nowhere and went 8-8. And had statistically played better than the Packers, you see. So honestly, they should be in the playoff team, perhaps. And the Bears continue to fall apart at 7-9. So much for making the Super Bowl almost 3 years ago. And look at this, the NFC South. The Saints stunned us. The Saints, at the beginning of the year, lost Drew Brees as they started off 2-0, I think it was. And then they lost their next 4 games. And then when he came back, they surged and ended up winning all the remaining games to finish 12-4 and getting home field advantage. And the Panthers, as the two-time champs, actually took a pretty big step back as they fell down to 11-5 and didn't even win the NFC South this time around. The Falcons start off 4-0, surprisingly, but then they crapped out and finished 6-10, and the Buccaneers continue to struggle in their rebuild at 3-13. The NFC East, the Redskins, with Pro Bowl quarterback Chad Henne, had a really strong start, but then he was out for several weeks near the end of the year, and they went from 9-3 to 9-6, and they won their final game of the year to manage to just get into the playoffs with him coming back. The Giants were a much better team than the Redskins, but they choked it and missed the playoffs. First time they missed the playoffs in this scenario after making the playoffs 6 years in time in a row. The Eagles had their nice rebound from 1-15. The Cowboys just continued to fall apart. NFC West, the Seahawks had an impressive bounce up year. I didn't think this was going to happen. And then the Rams, at first they struggled here, then all of a sudden they surged and ended up winning like 5 in a row. They were 8-5. It looked like they could still make a guaranteed run for the wild card round, but then they choked their final games to lose out. Cardinals had a bad year with Matt Leinart missing half a season with injury, as I'm probably sure they're going to probably get rid of him at the end of the year. And the 49ers had a nice bounce back after 2-14 last year, but 4-12 still bad. So you had the Bills, playoffs for the second year in a row. Won the AFC East for second year in a row. They got first round bye first time since 1993 and home field advantage for the first time since 1993. Broncos, playoffs, division, and first round bye for the first time since 2005. As I said, the first time they are in the playoffs in my franchise mode. Jaguars, playoffs, division for the second year in a row, or at least the playoff appearance for the third year in a row. Ravens won the division playoff berth for the fourth year in a row. Then the Chiefs got in the playoffs for the fourth year in a row, but this time as a wild card team. And the Dolphins in the playoffs for the fourth year in a row, but once again, second year is the wild card team as they just can't beat the Bills. And the NFC Saints made the playoffs for the fourth year in a row, but won the NFC South first round bye and home field advantage for the first time since their Super Bowl run in 2010, where they fell short to the Colts. Lions playoffs for the fourth year in a row, and they won the NFC North for the third year in a row and clinched first round bye for second year in a row. Seahawks playoffs, NFC West for second year in a row. Redskins made the playoffs for the first time since 2007 and won the NFC East for the first time since 1999. This is the first time they made the playoffs in my franchise mode. The Panthers were in the playoffs for the third year in a row, and the Packers got in for the second year in a row. So I'm trying to think of, there's probably like six or something teams left that have yet to make the playoffs in my scenario. But anyways, in the playoffs, it was the Dolphins at the Ravens and the Chiefs at the Jaguars, and the NFC was the Panthers at the Redskins and the Packers at Seahawks. The Seahawks beat the Packers, and then the Redskins beat the Panthers because Trent Edwards didn't play that game due to injury, so the three-peat for the Panthers was ruined. No three-peat this time around. Meanwhile, on the AFC side, the Jaguars beat the Chiefs, and then the Dolphins on the road beat the Ravens, the AFC champ last year, because they had injuries too. And in the divisional round, the Dolphins were at the Bills, and the Bills beat them, so they are in the AFC championship for the second year in a row. And then the Jaguars are at the Broncos, and the Broncos won it in a defensive overtime struggle. And they were in the AFC Championship for the first time since 2005. Then the Redskins were at the Saints, and the Saints dominated them. They were in the NFC Championship for the first time since 2010. And then the Seahawks were at the Lions. The Lions pretty much took care of them. They were in the NFC Championship for the third year in a row. So the AFC Championship, Broncos at Bills. Bills dominated them, and they were in the Super Bowl for the first time since 1993. And then the Lions at Saints, and once again, third year in a row, the Lions could not make the Super Bowl on the road as the Saints held on to win it. So our Super Bowl is the Saints and the Bills. Actual correct spots too in the playoffs, since the Bills are supposed to be the home team this year. So it's come down to this now. I already set the controls up, set the 3-minute quarters, because I did 15-minute quarters for the rest of the speed for the season. Alright, so everything's set. So will it be the Saints finally getting their first title in their 46-year wait, or will it be the Bills getting their first title since 1965, 48 years ago? One of these long streaks are going to finally come to an end. Will it be the Saints? Matter of fact, too, I want to look at something, too. Thankfully, they don't have really too much injuries, but I'm quite curious about something. Oops, NFC. The two best offense in the league, the Bills' number one offense, and the Saints are number two by just 1 point. That's incredible. Meanwhile, defense, 282. So the Bills have the number one defense in the league tied with the Seahawks. So, like, that's something. I wonder where the Saints are. 302. So the Bills have the number one offense in the league and tied the Seahawks for number one defense in the league. So that's a perfect team, pretty much. Meanwhile, the Saints have the number two defense. Number two offense and the third best defense in the league. That's really impressive. These two teams are really good. And the Bills actually did play the Saints early in the year when Breeze was out. Actually, no, I think Breeze came back for this game. But, of course, it was at home, so the Bills got that easily, pretty much. So, will it be the Saints getting their revenge? I guess we're going to find out. Man, this is going to be one incredible showdown. Will it be close? Unlike the last two games, pretty much. Last Super Bowl where the Ravens got stomped by the Panthers. But here we go. It's time. Saints, Bills, one of these long streaks are going to finally come to... Wait. Okay. I don't know why I did that, so... Alright, let me just reload. I could have swore I pressed play game. Alright, so let's try this once again. Make sure everything is correct. And here we go. Advanced. Oh boy, I can't wait for this. This was not the Super Bowl I expected at the beginning of the year. Although I did expect the Bills to maybe be a contender, I didn't think they were going to go freaking 15-1, and nor did I think the Saints were going to make the playoffs, especially after Breeze went down with his injury. All right, Bills won the coin toss, and they receive. As we're in East Rutherford, remember, this is the Super Bowl I went to in real life. Ah, look at that. They put the game in this in New St. Louis. Ah, we're in the Edward Jones Dome. Ain't that funny? But this is Super Bowl 48. We're supposed to actually be in East Rutherford. So here we go. Super Bowl 48 is now underway. As I got to switch over to the Bills really quickly after this quarter's over. I mean, it's drive. All right. Touchback. All right. Let's see the Bills with their quarterback. Rob Carr, I think his name was, or whatever it was. He was the number one overall pick in 2009 when they collapsed to 4-12. Let's see how he does it. He had a really good year. And the Saints are also the first team in the series to lose a Super Bowl and came back in my franchise mode. Let's see if they can win it this time around. Open, caught it, and got the first down. All right, nice start for the Bills. After that terrible 4-12 season in 2008, the Bills have done pretty good. They went the next 3 years like around 500 or so, but then these last 2 years, they just exploded out of nowhere as Carter got sacked before he handed the ball off. Yikes, that's not good. Saints, third best defense in the league, and so far showed up when it came to running the ball. Just like last year in Super Bowl, no one could run the ball. Davis, open, got it. First down, midfield. Well, so far, oh no, the Saints had an injury. Oh, that's not good. I have no idea how good he is, because remember, this is now year six of the franchise mode, so a lot of the create players are coming in now, replacing the real-life players at the time. There we go! Lynch got it open! First down, as he's still with the Bills, and he's been the main part of this offense still, just like he was with the Seahawks at the time. Well, so far, other than that one play, the Bills are playing good so far. Smith, open! Oh, he caught it right at the goal line! All right, the Bills are marching downfield, and they're going to go no huddle. Look at that, 77 yards already, just 13 yards rushing, but 64 passing. Not bad for the Bills so far. Here we go. Evans, open. Oh, out of bounds. Oh, first incompletion, too. Actually, you know what? We're going to try and run it again. Let's see if Lynch could get in. Of course, this is a different audio. Here we go. Running right up the gut. Although there's like seven Saints right there. It's not good. There we go. Got in. All right. Touchdown, Bills. They got in. They went for it, took the risk, and it paid off. So the Bills, in less than a minute, I think, too. Oh, a minute and 2 seconds. Marched downfield and took the first score of the game. Like I said, number one offense in the league by just 1 point over the Saints. That's incredible. The two best offenses in the league going at it. The number one defense going to be against the third best defense. And so far, a minute 58 in, the Bills are up on the Saints, 7-0. That's not the start the Saints won, because remember, 3 years ago, they played the Colts in the Super Bowl, and they actually got crushed pretty much before all of a sudden, like in the fourth quarter, final few minutes, they managed to get two touchdowns and make it a one-score game, but they pretty much lost the Colts by a mile. It was a spanking. It was a embarrassing loss for them. Reggie Bush had an opening. And Reggie Bush was one of the league's leaders in rush yards. He got over 2,100 yards. So let's see. Let's see how the number two offense league Breeze does against the Bills in their rematch from earlier in the year. And that went nowhere for Reggie Bush. No gain. Alright. If I remember in the Super Bowl 3 years ago, Breeze could not really pass effectively. Let's see how he does against the number one defense league, and of course, the controller fucking died on me again. This has been a massive problem lately. And almost screwed me up right there. Forced to throw. Oh! Oh no, Breeze injured again. Oh no. And honestly, you know what? That was really not fair because the controller fucked up on me. That was not fair. Because it sat there waiting and almost couldn't get the playoff because the damn controller fucked up. So I guess I'm going to have to save state every single play. That was not fair for the Saints to have that injury because the controller screwed me up. Alright, so let's try it again. Hopefully get tackled like around the 20 or so. Maybe I should have done a touchback. Alright, so the Saints look like I think have less yards than before. Save state. But yeah, this is what I actually did in my old friend when I did this, where I played every single game. I would save state every single quarter, I mean every single half's over and all. But during the Super Bowl, I actually go for like every single play, make sure nothing screw up happens. And there we go! Nice start there for the Saints. That's more fair. So got to the 40. And God forbid, that would suck if Breeze got knocked out again with an injury. That would be really, really bad. And there we go. Nice opening for Reggie Bush, and he got the first down. All right, Saints marching downfield with no effort so far. Oh my God, come on, Bush. Get to the line quicker. Nice, hoping in for a little bit. All right, gain 5 yards at least. Halfway there to midfield. Actually, I think you might be at midfield. Oh, no, you're at 45. Okay. All right, Bills, as you see right now, have the more off, I mean, more yards. Let's see if the Saints march downfield. They might actually take the lead in that regard. Dockett, open. Oh, oh, incomplete. Was open for a moment. But even on normal, they get shut up really quickly. Oh, Joe Mays out for a quarter now. Okay, well, the quarter's almost over, so probably not going to be the case for long. Paulson, you better get open, boy. Bush, open! And he caught it! And he's going to go in for the touchdown! All right, the Saints march downfield, too! And got their own touchdown. And honestly, less than a minute. Like, only 53 seconds or so. That was incredible. And the Saints, all right, so far this game looks like it could be offensive as hell. All right, Bush got open there. What a big play that was. It would go up and good. So, a minute and 5 seconds into the game. I mean, minute five left in the first, and the game's tied. Because remember, last year's Super Bowl between the Ravens and Panthers, there was no scoring at all, I believe, in the first and third quarter. It was only in the first and second and fourth. So far, this game's going much better than last year's Super Bowl. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. The Bills got an opening, perhaps. Oh, around the 40. But that was a nice return, though, to the 39. All right, we saw Carter march down. Actually, no. Well, Carter did get the march downfield. Let's see if they can go for another touchdown, perhaps. Ah, had to force the throw. Caught, though, at least. And got the first down and extra. Ooh, that looked like both horse collar and face mask right there. That definitely didn't look right. But man, that looked bad for the Bills, but they actually got the first down and much, much more. I should expect much. Oh my God. And he sacked. He was trying to find an open receiver, but there was none available, and there's no button I know of to throw it away, unfortunately. Big sack right here. What? No. Oh my God, I hope I can audible. Oh my God, no, audible, of course, had to time out. I have no idea why I did a spike. And of course, for some reason, this game, you can't do an audible when you're spiking. It won't let you, or at least, I don't know how, because it's not doing it normally. All right, so forced to take a timeout, which was bullshit, unnecessary. Smith, open. Let's see, could he haul it in? Oh, he did! Oh my goodness, he did! And the Bills are at the goal line again! Wow, they're tight end having a big game already. 86 yards off of free catches. Hurry up, Bills. Offense, get to the line before the half. I mean, the quarter's over. Smith! Oh no! Oh, Smith was right there. I don't know what happened. Maybe it got blocked or something. Oh man, it was right there. Right there for the catch. And the ball, something happened. It didn't get thrown properly. Oh man, it was right there too for the touchdown. That bites. Open. Caught that time. And another touchdown for the Bills. And that was Rob Carter's first passing touchdown in the Super Bowl. As we'll already switch over to the Saints now. Damn! This game is offensive. Maybe this could be like the Bengals-Eagles Super Bowl 4 years ago, remember? Bengals won that, I think it was like 44-42. Comes in to attempt the point after. So here we go. Yeah, remember the 2008? As here we go. I think it was like 12 seconds left in the first quarter, and the Bills are now up 7 in 14-7. I remember in 2008, it was the Rams beating the Saints. It was like 49-17. Or something like that. Then in 2009, it was the Bengals beating the Eagles 44-42. 2010 was the Colts beating the Saints 31-24. Then in 2011, it was the Panthers beating the Chiefs. I think it was 31-24 as well, or something like that. And then last year's Super Bowl, the Panthers beating the Ravens, it was 30-18. This game definitely more offensive than last time. Let's see what the Saints could do on their second drive. Ooh, what a big hit there. Halston, open, first down. Nice. Man, they're just really marching downfield with no effort, and there we go. First quarter over as the Bills up 14-7. So I'm sure the Bills, although they're on the other side of New York, even though it's in St. Louis, you know they're probably going to have a home field advantage this game as they desperately want that first Super Bowl, but their first title. Oh, nice! Nice juke right there! Nice stiff arm for Reggie Bush as they got the first down. All right. That was nice. As you see right now, the Bills have more yards and held the ball longer, but the Saints march it outfield. Well, 4 yard gain. Oh no! And I think he's a good defensive player too. And I think he's an actual player. Oh, that's not good for the Bills. That's not good. We've already had two injuries on each side. Saints injury should be back in, I believe, too. Colston! Oh, he's open! He should get it! And he got it! And the Saints got another touchdown! Colston was wide open on that play. What a bad hole that was for the Bills. That was the number one defense in the league, and they just got shredded on a 50-yard pass. As Breeze, I think, threw his... Yeah, that's two passing touchdowns that Breeze threw like from like 50-plus yards. I would say right now, Breeze is outplaying Carter. That's pretty bad for the Bills because they have the number one defense in the league, and they're getting shredded like this. But now the game is tied up at 14 again. But yeah, like I said, looks like this game is going to be all offense. No defense is going to save this game, looks like, right now. Unless, another big return for the Bills. That's really helping them, too, getting those big kickoff returns. That's the second one in a row. Last one from 39. This one's from 30. All right, as you see, Saints now have the offensive lead, both passing and rushing yards. Bills have only rushed for 15 yards, look like it said. And Lynch, that's not good. Lynch only gained 2 yards. I mean, Lynch, you're like the main part of this Bills offense. You got to do a little bit better than that, buddy. You got to get those stiff arms like Reggie Bush did earlier. That was just incredible. Oh, Lynch! He got hit from behind, only gained 1 yard. Okay, that's not good for the Bills. Their main strength is running the ball and out for the game. Two straight running plays, only gained 3 yards. First a big third and long now. Evans, oh no! Got hit as he was about to throw, and the Bills got stopped. Oh man, just when Carter was about to throw. Oh boy, could this be a big opportunity now for the Saints? Because remember, they get the ball start the second half, so if they burn off a lot of time and get a touchdown here, they can get the ball back to start the second half, and they can get another touchdown. Alright, just what the Saints pretty much needed. A nice return. Alright, here we go. The last play of the second quarter. Well, the 2 minute warning, I mean to say. There's a nice hole right there if it could stay open. And there we... it got shut down. Okay, so looked like only a 2 yard gain. Yep, second 8. I see Saints still have the lead. No running the ball. Just all passing. Sanders open, and he got it. And he almost got away from that tackle. Made to the midfield now. Past midfield actually. They're going to play action again. So far, Drew Brees has not been stopped in this game. Colston, double covered. Overthrown. Actually, it was the offense, the defensive players that stopped him from making. So honestly, by this game's logic, it should have been pass interference. And that actually has happened before, plays like that. Double covered, defense ahead of you, and they block the receiver from making a catch because they're just in the way. That's actually been called pass interference numerous times before. Here we go for another pass. As Bush is open again! And he goes! Oh, he finally got it right there! Oh my god! Oh my goodness, can you imagine if he dropped that? That would have been devastating. Bush, have an incredible game right there. And the Saints are right at the goal line. Well, red zone technically, they're not at the goal line yet. Here they go for another pass. Colston, he got it! Oh, 1 yard short looks like. 1 yard short. And Colston with another big game. Oh my god, the Saints might take their first lead right here. Here we go. As they're going to go in and look. lost yards! They tried to run it like the Bills did, but it did not work because they lost 2 yards. That's not good. Oh my goodness. Colston and Bush have been non-stoppable so far in this game. This is just crazy. Colston open, and he got it! Touchdowns, and the Saints take their first lead of the game. 3 passing touchdowns by Breeze already. Incredible. Yeah, the Bills are going to really regret not getting anything going that last drive because they could have been in better position, but now they're down. 21-14 to the Saints. They got 1 minute and 1 second left. They got to get something here because the Saints are going to get the ball start the second half, and so far right now, they are unstoppable. So the Bills are in a little bit of a hole right here. They better get a score here. This one is handled by number 28. Here we go. That kickoff return once again helping them. 29. All right. Yeah, they're going to have to pass it. Where's... Okay, there's Lynch. Lynch, make yourself useful. Get open in the passing game. And he did! All right. Now, of course, I got to be careful, too, because the Bills only have 2 timeouts. Remember, because I had to use that one on that snap play, that spike play that popped up out of nowhere. Lynch, open again! And he got it! Nice hole right there! All right. Oh, no! Oh, no! Carter's out! Oh, no! Oh, no! Rob Carter is out! Oh, no! Okay, he's returning, but who knows how long it's going to be. Who is his backup? I have no idea who he is, a custom player. Oh, no! That's going to hurt the Bills without Carter. All right. Love, whatever you are, you're the backup for hopefully a little, only one play, maybe, as we need Carter back badly. Evans, open! Right there! And oh, no! It was picked! Oh, why'd you go? Oh, what the fuck was that? What the fuck was that? The Bills get the safety. What? You caught an interception? You kept on going out of bounds? I really don't know what to say. I honestly want to, like, restart that because that's bullshit. That helps the Bills unrealistically, but I don't think I saved any time recently. That seems bullshit. What happened there? The Saints picked it off, but they went back into the end zone for a safety. Are you serious? That could be like the best thing to help the Bills. Oh my god, I can't believe what I just saw. I was like wondering, like, wait a minute, why are you going that way for? And I can't control him either, remember. Oh my god, I can't believe what I just saw. Well, actually, I have one way. Wait, no. I better be careful. All right, I think it's this button. Yeah, hey. Okay, it was after the Saints got that field goal. So I'm going to accept it. So apparently, the Bills threw an interception after Carter went out. And the Saints stupidly went back into their own end zone for a safety. So now the Bills, with 33 seconds left, are going to get the ball back down by 5. I hope that does not have any factor in this game. But of course, for that to happen, that would mean the Saints would have to win for me to feel comfortable about this. I just can't believe what happened. Why would you do that? I don't get it. Why did that Saints defensive player keep going? I don't know why he didn't turn around or something. Oh, God. He's still not in the game yet. And Love going to probably throw another pick, maybe. That's not good, but they need to try something here. Evans, open. Got it. But now they're going to have to time out. Oh, my God. Now Evans is injured. Oh, my God. Bills can't stop. They've lost their quarterback for who knows how long. Now they've lost their wide receiver for who knows how long. Oh, my God. The Bills are suffering so many injuries right now. Nothing's going their way. Hardy. Oh, you better hold it. Oh, yes, he did. Oh, no. Out of bounds. And there's no... And we can't challenge it because past 2 minute warning. Oh, man. That was big help right there. They needed that grab. And, of course, Carter still not in. Hardy, you better get open. Caught it. Oh, get out of bounds. Oh, no, he didn't get out of bounds in time. Spike, 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 spike. Why did you spike it? No. No. I don't know why you didn't spike it like you were supposed to. I hit the right button. Run.
On.
Caught, but oh no! Out of bounds. Didn't get out of bounds in time. Oh man. I don't know what happened there. I hit triangle, which is spike in this game. So why didn't you go for the spike? Maybe could have had enough time to go, maybe close up to do a field goal, maybe. Well, at least you could say the Bills didn't score again to make it a little bit more fair. Maybe you could say the Saints got that turnover and just got stuffed backwards and the Bills got the safety, but they couldn't do anything in time, maybe. So I could maybe say that's a little bit more fair. So right now, the Saints lead the Bills 21-16, and we need to find out what is going on with Carter. Okay, it doesn't say he's injured, but, I mean, God, this is just crazy what happened right there. Why didn't you spike it like you were supposed to? I don't get it. I have no idea. I hope the controller didn't die when that happened, too. All right, of course, you hear in the background, you see right there. The Saints have the lead in terms of passing yards, I mean yards and totals. Here we go, second half. Let's see if the Saints can start putting... Oh, touchback around the helmet. So let's see now, could the Saints start putting that... putting the dagger right into the back of the Bills and get like a 12-point lead here. They got to start running the ball too. They can't just rely on Breeze the entire game. And there we go, Bush! Big gain and all, oh, just short of the first down. But hey, looks like they're going to go to strategy what the Panthers did last year with the Ravens. Just keep running the ball and wasting time keeping the Bills off the field, especially when you can get all these first downs. And there we go. Got just barely the first down. All right. Well, I see the Saints still have the lead in terms of yards. 200 yards each by both teams passing. That's pretty impressive. Sanders, uh-oh, he's triple covered! Oh, how the fuck do you not pick that off? That should have been picked off like twice! It was right there in your hands. That should have been a Bills turnover right there. That is bullshit. But of course, incomplete. So let's see what the Saints could do right here. Not the player I wanted to throw to, but got the catch though still, thankfully. I wanted to throw to X receiver, but wouldn't throw it. I hit triangle or whatever by mistake. So third and one now, and no, we're going to run it in. We wasted almost a minute, which is a good amount of time right here. Here we go. Run it right up the side, and we'll... Oh, no, got sent backwards. Oh, just short. Oh, man. But wait, actually, you know what? We're going to try it. No, we're going to try it. Fourth and inches. We almost made it last time. Let's see if we can get it again. Here we go. And got it! No! Oh, no. The Saints tried, but they failed. But now the Bills got the ball deep in Saints territory. Could this be a chance now for the Bills to take the lead now? The Saints tried, but they fell short. Very risky play right there. Just couldn't get it. I was thinking about maybe going play action, but in the end, ended up not happening. And there we go. Lynch! Nice hole right there. Finally! And the Bills retake the lead. That is what the Bills needed earlier in this game. But he wouldn't show up. And there we go. Now the Bills retake the lead. And you know what? Yeah, they're going to go for it. Is Carter back in? Yes, Carter is finally back in. Force the throw! Deflected! Oh my god! Oh, it was deflected and almost could have been picked off maybe or whatever. All right. So a minute 55 now in the third quarter. The Bills are now up 22-21. So the Bills now take the lead. So let's see if they can maintain now as they now scored, what was it, 8 unanswered points now. This one is handled. One weakness for the Saints. There we go. That's the one weakness, though, for the Saints, I would say, is that they can't get a good kickoff return, whereas the Bills have been successfully getting it over and over and over again. So you see, now the Bills once again take the lead in terms of yards. Breeze forced the throw, and Bush caught it, but gained 2 yards. Okay, I thought it was 9. Oh my god, another Bills injury. Are you serious? That's like the fourth injury they've had in this game. All right, second and 8. Here we go. And oh, God, sank it down. Lost a yard. Oh, man. All right, the Saints really have lost, look like, a bit of momentum so far after that incredible first half. I got an idea. Audible. All right, here we go. Forced to make the throw. Catch and caught it. Oh, my goodness. He actually caught it. Bush, there he goes. What a risky play. And it paid off. And the Saints take the lead. Oh, my goodness. I was hoping for Bush to get open right there. I didn't think it was going to happen. He actually caught it and went all the way for the touchdown. And that was Breeze's fourth passing touchdown of the game. And look at that. Reggie Bush, 163 yards in this game. Incredible. And now the Bills are going to try a two-point conversion. And they got in. They got in that time. And now the Saints take the lead 29-22. With a minute 15 remaining in the third. Wow, what a play that was. Breeze got to be over 300 yards passing or really close. Yeah, an 83-yard pass. That's got to be very close to 300 yards. Incredible play right there. It was a big risk, and it paid off. Now let's see the Bills. And that time, that was a bad return. All right, now they need to get a touchdown just to tie it. The Bills had a moment of possibility idea. Maybe they can start turning around, but no, they let that big play happen, and that stinks. Evans open, got it, first down. All right, all right, so Bills got that first down as their number one defense has been shredded so far, allowing almost 30 points in this game alone, and Breeze put up four touchdowns on their asses. Sanders open, caught it. All right, so another first down at least. So let's see the same play again. As here we go, another play, another passive play. Oh, almost got picked right there. Ball was gonna throw over the Vilma right there. It was. I thought he wasn't gonna make it. Oh my goodness, that would have been disaster right there for the Bills. Here we go. Coverage. Yes. One more man. Oh, you couldn't cover the one man. All right. Third and five. Gained 5 yards. Crunch time for the Bills as safe state. Oh, Hardy, if your ass gets open or someone gets open. Evans open. He could have maybe got that first. Oh, my God. There he goes. And Evans did what Hardy almost could have done. It got the touchdown. I saw Hardy was open, but I didn't feel comfortable throw as Evans was right there. And not only did he caught it, he went all the way for the touchdown. Wow. This game is offensive and crazy as hell, just like the Eagles-Bengals won 4 years ago. Here we go. Up, and it's good. And with 20 seconds remaining in the third, the game is tied up at 29 now. As, wow, both these teams are desperate to get... Like I said, this will be the Saints' first title in their 46-year history, and the Bills trying to get their first title in their in 48 years. Now, although this would be their first Super Bowl, though, Saints don't have a title. The Bills already got two in real life. And there, Reggie Bush! Oh, my goodness! Reggie Bush! When they need him, Reggie Bush sealing himself as the MVP of the game with a big kickoff return to retake the lead. Oh, my God! Reggie Bush! What a play! He's had over 160 yards receiving already, like two or three passing touchdowns, and now a kickoff return? He has got to be the MVP candidate. I'm sorry, Breeze. Your performance is incredible, but Bush single-handedly deserves that MVP honor in my eyes. And the Bills are now up 30. I mean, the Saints are now back up 36-29 with 9 seconds remaining. Holy crap. Now the Bills, you've had a better performance in kickoff returns. You better get a good kickoff return too. And oh my God, you did. Oh man. You've not done well when it comes to that in the last bunch of plays. I mean, last bunch of kickoff returns. Oh my goodness, I still can't believe what happened there on that play. Open and out of bounds. They have, nope, that was it. That's the end of the third quarter as the Saints are up 36-29 as they smell it, that first title. But the Bills still have some fight in them. and they're not giving up yet.
Here we go.
Hardy, he's going to try going long. Hardy, could he get it? And he, oh, Hardy, oh, pass interference though. Pass interference, and the Bills got the ball at the 28. All right, so the Bills have a chance still. Big play right there, and a big penalty, costly too. And the Bills, oh, Lynch, nice. Nice game right there, gained 7 yards. And then we see 361 yards for the Bills as they have the lead in terms of yards, but they're down by a touchdown still. Got a nice hole. There goes Lynch. Oh, man. Another first down, though. The Bills are getting within range to tie it up, though. And they're going to go for a play-action pass. This is the play I wanted to do earlier for the Saints. Look at that. Now the Bills are running the ball effectively now compared to the Saints. And oh, that should have been picked again. Oh, my God. It was supposed to have overthrown, too. Oh, man. Couldn't get it, though. Those tip passes can turn into interceptions pretty easily. Here we go, run that ball again. And oh, Lynch had to run the ball so well, lost a yard. That's not good. Good play by the linebacker to get into the backfield and stop. Here we go, play action again. Third and 11 here. They really badly need that touchdown because they're getting torched. Hardy, and he will get it! Overthrown, and the Bills tie the game up again. All right. Great job. They're not. I'm thinking about maybe going for a two-pointer, but no. We're just gonna go. We're just gonna get that extra point. Just think though, if they did get that extra point, they would be taking this like 2-point lead right here. Maybe they would have gone for it. But with 2:16 remain, the game is retied back up at 36 apiece now. All right, so the Bills managed to march downfield just what they needed, and they probably put up 400 yards of offense right now. Final 2:16 left in the game. Could the Saints go downfield and try and get that lead and win the Super Bowl? We will find out as here we go. Let's see what the Saints can do as they're going to try and run it to start off. As here we go, as they're getting to the line. Got a few plays left. Maybe this might be the final play before 2-minute warning, perhaps. And nice gain. Gained 4 yards. All right, we'll see if they can get off another play in time, maybe. They're running for it. They're trying to get to the line. As you see, the Bills have the lead right there. Here we go. Get that playoff just in time. And Bush! Oh, 1 yard short. 1 yard short as looks like going to be it for a 2-minute warning. Yeah, they're not going to get that off in time. And nope. 2-minute warning now. Big crucial third down now. They're going to go for it. They're going to put their trust in Reggie Bush. Let's see if he can do it one more time. And there he goes! And there he goes! Nice break right there! First down! And the Saints still got the ball! Oh my God, Reggie Bush has single-handedly been unstoppable. He's destroyed everyone. Look at that. Bills have the lead, but the Saints have just single-handedly just destroyed the Bills' defense so far in this game. Colston! Open! Oh! He could go all the way! He's open! At the 40! At the 30! At the... Oh! Got to the 25! All right! Oh no! Marquise Colston injured! That's going to hurt the Saints' offense! But hey, at least they're in field goal, well, close to field goal range. So they might play it safe and just try and get that field goal. And maybe try and throw out the Bills' timeouts. Here we go. As they're running for it. Oh, there's Bush again! Trying to stiff arm! Got the first down right at the goal line too! Oh, right! Incredible! Oh no, Colston's out for the game. That's going to hurt, but the Bills... The Saints are still marching downfield, and the Bills are going to call their timeout. All right, so that leaves the Bills with two left. Yeah, it looks like the Saints are going to maybe run the ball, maybe try and burn out enough time to maybe force a field goal, maybe. Or at least force the Bills to have no timeouts. Oh, no, there goes Bush, and he's going to go in! Touchdown, Saints! Their first touchdown without Breeze throwing a pass, and Reggie Bush got so once again, he's setting himself up as the MVP candidate. Oh my God, I can't wait to look at his stats when this game's over. This is incredible how well he's done this game. And the Saints, let's see. They're going, wait for that extra point. Here we go, up. Good. And 1:26 remaining in the game. The Saints now lead 43-26. Could they do it? Could they clinch their first ever title? But it's still plenty of time. Minus their one timeout still. They still can, Bills can still go down and tie it maybe. They need a big kickoff returner to help out there. Oh, that's big right there. Oh, one. Oh, had two blocks right there. Two blocks. But that one right there. Oh, that was nice too, but couldn't get it. All right, a minute 22. Let's see. Could Carter show himself to indeed be one of the best quarterbacks in the league? As here we go. As Evans open, and he caught it. First down, and he went out of bounds. Smart, trying to save as much time as possible, but you don't want to save too much time because if you go on field and get a touchdown really quickly, then the Saints will have enough time to maybe get it. All right, let's see. Here we go. Another play. Hardy, open, and he got it. But that time, oh, maybe he went out of bounds. Oh, no, he's injured. Oh, my goodness. God, the Bills have so much injuries in this game to their offense, and they had to use another timeout. Oh, my God. The Bills can't get a break here. Well, at least they still got Carter. Here we go. Let's see what Carter can do. It's caught. Lynch again at the 30. All right, maybe. Maybe they can burn out enough time. Maybe we go for the touchdown to tie it and force overtime, maybe. All right, they're going to run the ball now. Let's see if Lynch can get some yards. As he was forced to go back, and he lost yards. Wasted a lot of time and lost yards. That's not good. Lost 3 yards, actually. All right, here we go. They got one timeout, I think, left, and they need to go downfield in 42 seconds. Here we go. They go for the pass. Jones. Oh, that should have been pass interference. That should have been pass interference just like earlier. Oh, man, here we go now. Third and 12. Okay, he'll return, but we need him right now, though. We need him, like, right fucking now. Here we go. Jones. He caught that time. All right, first down. As there we go, another play action pass. Final 30 seconds. You gotta be careful though. Okay, that could still leave a lot of time for the Saints to go for a touchdown or field goal themselves, maybe. Gotta be careful. And he got it! And he, oh, 1 yard short! 1 yard short! All right, just 1 yard short of tying it. Here they go. They're gonna run. They still got some time left, and they got timeout still, I think. Wait. Oh, yeah, they got one more timeout. Here we go. Going for it. And no! Lynch tackled short! Oh, they're gonna have to use their timeout now. All right, come down to this. Unfortunately, if the Bills get a touchdown, they might leave just a little bit of time remain. And look, they already gave Reggie Bush the MVP of the game, but the game could go into overtime maybe, so I'm not going to say yet. We'll wait and see what happens at the end of the game before I crown yet. Here we go. Caught. Oh, it was picked! It was picked! Oh, no! Ain't going to be tackled! Oh, my! Tried to force that touchdown, and it was picked off at the goal line. Oh, my! Wow. Why would you go for it? They've ran out of timeouts. Just kneel it. Oh, my goodness. So close, but just couldn't get in. Like at the 3 yard line. And once again, there's still no. Oh, my God. Oh, man. The Bills tried so hard. Tried to force that throw in between the area, but forced that pick. And the Saints. One kneel down for way if I could just freaking find it. There we go. Jesus Christ, it took that long for it just to appear. I don't know why Madden wouldn't recommend since they have no timeout, so why not do it? And there we go. That most likely will be it as they have no timeouts. Wow, the Bills marched downfield trying to tie the game up, but they fell short. And with that, the game is over. The Saints have won the Super Bowl. They beat the Bills 43-36. And they've clinched their first title in their 46-year existence. Wow, what a game that was. Let's take a look at those stats. Look at Drew Brees, 12 of 15, 338 yards. A perfect game, too, and 4 touchdowns. Carter, he was good, but that touchdown is going to really hurt. Oh, man. Man, that was just crazy what happened. Just think, too, maybe if they didn't get that safety, instead maybe going out and got that touchdown, maybe they would have been a much better situation. Maybe they could have gone for a field goal and maybe won it or tie it. But, of course, that's the crazy thing that happened in this game, and I can't change that, unfortunately. As now we take a look. I see Reggie Bush. Yes, he is definite MVP candidate. 16 carries for 74 yards. Lynch had a good game in terms of getting touchdowns, but not really that much yards. But then we go to receiving. Look at that. 4 receptions, 163 yards. He had 4 touchdowns in total. 2 passing, 1 rushing, and a kickoff return. Matter of fact, if you add it up, 163 as, let me get my phone, because I'm quite curious. It was 163. So, take that in, 163 plus 74 from the rushing yards. Now let's see if we can look up kickoff returns, maybe. 144. Fucking Reggie Bush had 381 yards in this game in total. Oh my goodness. So let's see. The Saints had 400 and... So that means, in total, Reggie Bush accounted for only all the yards that the Saints had except for 30. He had 381 yards in total. Actually, there's the total yards, okay? But I was looking at the total offense, my mistake. But, I mean, that's still really impressive if you think about it. 381 divided by 555. That means Reggie Bush accounted for 68.64% of the entire yards the Saints had in this game. He did over 2/3 of the yards. Incredible. He definitely deserved the MVP honor. It's not even debatable. As we still got to look up the rest of the individuals in this game. Receiving yards, Marquise Colson did good, although it sucks that he got injured. He had 2 touchdowns, though. That was really good. Oh, wow. Their fullback had a really good game in terms of rushing yards and passing as well. But, yeah, the Bills had a lot of injuries that those 2 turnovers did hurt. Although that 1 turnover did actually lead the points, so it actually helped them in one way. Although I'm sure they would rather have had a field goal or a touchdown instead. And, of course, that injury by Rob Carter definitely didn't help at that in the second half. I bet if they had him, they might have gone for it. Maybe because if they got that touchdown instead of the safety, they would have been down 41-43. So they could have gone instead for the touchdown to tie it. They could have gone for the field goal to take the 1-point win. The Bills had this though, even though their defense completely didn't show up. But unfortunately for the Bills, that's just not what happens in this game. They had their chance, but unfortunate bad circumstances once again blew it as they are once again 0-5 in the Super Bowls. 20 years later, make it back to the Super Bowl, and they just couldn't handle it. Meanwhile, for the Saints, I know it sucked for you 3 years ago losing to the Colts, but now it feels good. You finally are champs. So that will wrap up this video as the Saints beat the Bills 43-36 to clinch their first Super Bowl in their 46-year history. Now, I was wondering if the Saints were going to begin to start to collapse this year and look like it was not going to look good when Breeze went down with his injury at the beginning of the year, but they managed to recover, rally, and get it. Now, could they do it again next year is the question. Could they do what the Panthers did just two years ago now? Back to back. It's not going to be easy, that's for damn sure, but we'll see if they could try. So, tune in eventually soon for Super Bowl 49 down in Glendale. When we'll see what happens then, but congratulations to the Saints beating the Bills 43-36 to clinch your first Super Bowl in your history. See you guys next time.